In the last class, we were discussing one letter having two sounds. One letter assumes a different sound under certain conditions. We have already seen the conditions. Let me test whether you have followed it all right. Can you read this? This is a and this is tu. What will be the pronunciation? The pronunciation will be adu, meaning that. Now you have to remember this is tu. Because this is preceded by another letter, it assumes the sound of du, adu, that. You can read it easily. This is adu and this is idu. Naturally, this will be this. These are all demonstrative pronouns. Definitely, there is no difficulty. This is ye, tu, yedu, yedu, which. In the last class, we had discussed the letter ka and ta. You shall have a few more words so that it will be easy for you to remember and practice. Can you read it correctly? This is ka, ta, yel. It is not katal, it is kadal. Why this ta is pronounced as da? Because it is preceded by another letter. Ka, da, yel, kadal. Kadal is the sea. With this, I would like to take up another word with one more letter and then make you guess. I have deliberately used this word. Here you see you have a three-lettered word wherein this ta, a plosive, occurs in between two letters. As a result, you followed that definition and pronounced it as da, ka, da, il, kadal. Here, I am trying to put two more letters after ta and see whether there will be any change in the pronunciation. Now, you have to read it. This is ka, this is ta, this is, I hope you remember, if you don't, this is va plus wu, wu, ka, ta, wu, yil, ka, ta, wu, yil. Now, having the same formula repeated here, this will be ka, da, wu, yil, ka, da, wul. Ka, da, wul is the great god. So, this is kadal and this is kadavul. From ka, we have gone to ku. Ku, ta, yim. Ku, da, yim. Kudam. Kudam, a pot. Padam. Padam. Padam is a lesson. All the time I have been giving you words which were nouns. Now I would like to introduce slowly a few words which are verbs in nature. Let me start with the verb odu. Odu. Odu is to run. Odu. And padu, to sing. Tedu. Tedu, to search. Let me see whether you can read this by yourself. What is this? Ko do. Ko do. Ko do. Ko do, to give. This is just an elongation of this kodu. Kodu. Kodu is not a verb, it's a noun. A line. We do. We do. We do is a house. Naturally, kadu is a forest. You have a weed, that's a house. You have a kadu, that's a forest. And what's the word for the country? Nadu, nadu, nadu as a noun means a country. Can you read? Ta, mi, il, na, du, together. Tamil, Tamil, we have already come across. Nadu, Nadu, we have learned just now. I put them together and this becomes Tamil Nadu, Tamil Nadu, the Tamil country. Tamil Nadu. We are studying Tamil and the land where this is spoken is Tamil Nadu. You will be wondering why I have been giving so many words with two. Now I am switching over to E. Che D. Che D. Che D is a plant. E-D, thunder. When you have a thunder, naturally you must have a lightning also. So, I would give this word now and you should make an attempt to read it by yourself. What is this? Can you recognize this letter? This is ma with e marker, me, and this is n, the last letter of the Tamil alphabet, and this is na, the last alphabet with the vowel a, na, and then this is l, me, in, na, il, minnal. We have already come across that formula where certain letters are doubled. When they are doubled, the first letter will be a consonant and the next one will be a consonantal vowel. So, in this combination, you find the doubling having its effect. So, mi, in, na, il, minnal. Minnal means the lightning. Minnal. Let me have another word. This is not a Tamil word, but I want you to know the spelling and also be familiar with this word, since this is being used quite frequently. Do you remember this letter you have learned just now? Ja, in, na, il, jannal. You see, this is minnal and this is jannal. I have changed only the first letter, and jannal means a window. Erudu, erudu, to write. You learnt it in the last class. What is the opposite of it? Naturally, padi, 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 to read. Now, slowly, we would like to make an attempt to have sentences. Now, what do you write? What do you want me to write? You want me to write a lesson. You have learnt it now. Paadam, a lesson. Paadam, erudu, write a lesson. I repeat it here. Paadam, padi. Paadam, this one word and this is another word. Paadam, padi, read a lesson. So, you have learned two words put together forming a sentence and each one having the second sound of one letter. This ta is having the second sound da. Here also you have that. Here ta has da sound and here ta has the da sound. Paadam erudu. Paadam padi. Kudi, kudi, kudi is to drink. This is kudi. Kodi. Kodi is a creeper and also a flag. Kodi, Kodi, it means a creeper or a flag. Padam, Padam, Padam is a picture. If I elongate it, this becomes Padam, means a lesson. So, this way we have covered Ka, Ta and Ta, all the three having the other sound. Now, we move on to Fa. Fa has this sound, and in between two letters or after a letter, it becomes Ba. So, where do we have this? You know this word. Ka, ip, pa, il, kappal. Do you remember? This is doubling. See, I repeat this doubling and the other way of pronunciation so that you can remember them together and also will be able to separate them. Kappal is a ship. With this, let me go to another letter connected with a ship. This also starts with Pa. I made use of Ta and Ka. Pa, Ta, Ku. This will be pronounced as Pa, Da, Gu. Pa, Da, Gu is a boat. See, first letter as Pa, there is no change in pronunciation. This Ta being in the middle becomes a Da. This Ka following the other two letters becomes Ga, pronounced as Ga. So, Pa, Da, Gu, Pa, Da, Gu, a boat. Take up this letter Pa. Pa has its original sound of Pa. And in doubling, as in Kappal, it retains the original Pa sound, Ip Pa. Now, what will happen if it becomes a middle letter or a last letter? E, in, pa, m, in, pam, because pa is preceded by other letters, this becomes ba, is pronounced as ba. E, in, ba, m, in, bam is pleasure. So, naturally, the opposite of it will be Tunbam, opposite of pressure, that is sorrow. Here also you find pa is preceded by two letters, inbam and tunbam. Let me give you another letter. This word has two letters preceding pa. This is pu. A in pu, an pu, an bu. An bu is love. This is a common term which can be used anywhere without any restriction. So, this stands for the motherly love, the paternal love, the fraternal love and all that. Anbu, even the love extended to a pet animal is anbu. So, inbam, tunbam and anbu will demonstrate where this pa assumes the ba sound. That is to say, if it is preceded by one or two letters or it remains as the last letter in a word, it assumes the sound pa. Then what was the other letter left? Cha. This cha becoming ja, you have already learned this letter and also its pronunciation. This is cha and this is ja. And this is a borrowed sound, and naturally this cha becomes ja whenever there is a borrowed word. So, I will take this up later. Now, to continue in the same trend, I am going to give you another formula where this ka, cha, ta, ta and pa assume another sound. Before that, we will have a small introduction, and this introduction will give you a review of all the letters you have learned. A review of all the letters of the Tamil language. You have completely familiar with all the letters of the alphabet, and now I am categorizing them into three. That is, you know vowel, the other is a consonant, and the third is a consonantal vowel. Vowel a, I, e, u, and it is called uyir eluthu. Uyir eluthu. Eluthu is a letter. You remember? Uyir eluthu vowel. And consonant is mei eluthu. And consonantal vowel, naturally, a combination of both. This is uyir mei eluthu. Uyir eluthu means vowel, mei eluthu means consonant, uyir mei eluthu means consonantal vowel. These are the three main categories of the Tamil alphabet. With all this, we are going into a new field of pronunciation following what we did the previous lesson about the assumption of a different sound of a particular letter. See you later.